He says he was driven by Satan, and now Quakers Hill killer Roger Dean will rot in hell. The worst mass murderer in our state's history was told today that he will never, ever be allowed out of prison. Andrew Denny is at the nursing home where Dean killed 11 elderly and helpless people. Andrew, has today's sentence brought any level of comfort for the families and loved ones of those poor victims?
Well, Sandra, a little comfort, but they all say nothing will ever make up for what Roger Dean stole from them. He was, of course, a nurse here when he set fire to the nursing home. 11 elderly residents died. He pleaded guilty to their murders, and today he received 11 life sentences.
You're guilty, the son of a got what he deserves.
For the first time in nearly 2 years, these families had a reason to smile.
Relief, yes. He won't do that to anybody else in the community.
Roger Dean was trusted with the lives of their parents. He ended them in the most heinous way imaginable, setting fire to the building with the frail and elderly trapped in their beds. 11 died, 8 were injured. Their names were read out to the court one by one to the sound of sobbing.
Hearing him getting a life sentence today makes me a lot more happier knowing that he's going to rot in jail and with no way of getting out with parole.
Amanda Tucker's grandmother was bedridden in the room where the blaze was started.
Every time we picture our Nana, we wonder whether she was in pain or if she was scared or screaming or needing help. And he walked straight past her and didn't help.
Cameras filmed Dean on the morning of the fire bragging about how he saved lives.
And I just quickly just did what I can, get everyone out, and the smoke is just overwhelming. But, you know, we got a lot of people out, so that's the main thing.
But only minutes earlier, he'd started it all to cover up his theft of hundreds of prescription painkillers. The day before the fire, security cameras captured him helping himself to drugs from the locked storage room 36 times. In the confusion of the fire, he snuck back in to cover his tracks.
It was like Satan saying to me that it's the right thing to do.
He'll now spend the rest of his life behind bars in a prison where he's already been attacked by other inmates.
And I hope he suffers as much in jail as my mother suffered the last 4 days of her life, which was horrendous.
Now, closure isn't really a word that many of these families have been using today. For them, closure would have been being able to say goodbye to their loved ones the way they expected, in the comfort and safety that this nursing home should have provided. As you can see, reconstruction of that home is well underway, and it will reopen in 2014. Sandra.
Okay, Andrew, thank you.